We'll get to Tom Brady in just a second, but first, a little baseball. Angels, Stros, Cole Calhoun chasing down the fly ball in right. Dives to make a nice catch.
Full extension. Oh, that's a great one right there, because if it gets past him, it's at least a double and maybe a triple.
And a tougher one, because he's a lefty, so he's got to go across his body with the glove. Yeah.
NBA Summer League Championship.
Yeah, I give you that.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Memphis, Minnesota Grizzlies guard Tyler Harvey on the front end of that alley-oop right there.
Coach tells him, throw it to the square. The big guy grab it.
Bruno goes up and gets it. The only Bruno we got in the NBA.
Boom. Boom. You didn't have to jump too high.
I don't think we ever had a Bruno in the NBA.
I know. One of one, see? One of one.
Finally, look, pick up basketball in Texas. You love these, Chris Carter. Kansas State redshirt quarterback John Holcomb II destroying the defenders. He dunks on him.
He's the K-State quarterback?
Quarterback.
The backup.
Oh.
Well, maybe he should be the starting shooting guard for the basketball team instead of the backup quarterback.
Yeah, these guys he's playing against, they played ball in high school, but they hadn't run into anybody like him.
Nice time of day there. All right, let's talk some football.
Middle of Kansas.
Tom Brady, soon to be 42-year-old, gearing up for his 20th season in the NFL. And while most would dread the wear and tear of another grueling season, the six-time Super Bowl champ is fully embracing it. Brady is reportedly, quote, excited as ever entering this season, a season in which Tom Terpik will be the oldest position player in the league. All right, see, what can we expect from Tom Brady and the New England Patriots?
Well, let's go back to last season. I think that a lot of times when you're moving forward, if you go backwards, it will give you a better look at what kind of team they were. Last year, we thought that, man, they had a chink in the armor. They weren't going to be as good. Their stats were very, very telling. What were they? People say Tom Brady, Gronk. Man, they were a running football team. When they didn't run the ball for 100 yards, they lost. Five times last season they didn't run, and you could see Sony Michel, you could see James White, you could see them leaning on their offensive line, the offensive line coach. That's their advantage. In the playoffs, they slowed the games down, played a game like in the 80s and the 90s, the way the NFL games were played, played stellar defense. As we saw in the Super Bowl, you can expect Gronk retiring, Sony Michel 1 year older, James White coming back. Edelman's going to be there in the slot from the beginning. That's the way they're going to move the ball down the field. It's not going to be pretty. They're not going to be taking a bunch of shots, deep shots down the field like Patty Mahomes and Kansas City or playing like the Rams. No, they're going to slow down the pace. They're going to make sure you don't get to Tom Brady. They're going to keep him fresh, try to get him to the playoffs. And just as easy as that, Jenna, they're going to win 12 games. On paper, do they look like it? No. But they're in the AFC East. It's been gift wrap for them the last 15 years. The incompetence, the inconsistency, the rookie quarterbacks, the changing of staffs, the lack of continuity in that division. That's why they've dominated. And that's why they'll win the division again this year.
Well, and last year you did see Brady in year 19. He had the lowest touchdown rate he's had in a decade. He had the highest interception rate he'd had in nearly a decade. He had his lowest passer rating in 5 years. You saw Brady, while excellent compared to the average NFL quarterback, below his regular standard. But how much of that was Tom Brady deteriorating, and how much of that was that they all year long, they brought in, what, 35 different receivers over the course of the offseason through the regular season? The problem for the Patriots is that receiver problem has not been solved. That question has not been answered. What they were searching for, by the way, if you noticed a few weeks ago, They kept control, if you will, over Josh Gordon, a guy who last year they thought could have been a lifeline for them. They're still holding out some hope maybe he could come back into the fold, because Philip Dorsett is their most reliable deep threat. They drafted N'Keal Harry in the first round, but it's very tough for first-round receivers, especially tail end of the first-round receivers, to make an instant impact. And now Gronk is gone.
Right.
So what Chris is talking about is their clearest path to victory is going to be excellent defense, very good running game, and trust your quarterback, who happens to double as not only the greatest quarterback ever, but arguably the most clutch quarterback ever as well, in the big spots to make a few big plays, because this isn't the 07 or the 2011 Pats where they have dynamic weapons that it's just going to be hard to match up against. You're going to see a lot of two tight end, that fullback that they love using. You'll see him, and they're going to try to beat you almost zig when the rest of the league is zagging, when we're becoming more of a finesse.
Which is their MO.
Absolutely.
Which is to outsmart another team, outscheme another team, and use Bill Belichick, which what mm-hmm. is really good at. But when you're a guy like Tom Brady, you have all these rings, you have all these accolades, your resume is so thick. What do you think motivates a guy like this going into, what, he's going to be 42 years old? At this point in his career, what do you think motivates Tom Brady?
He won't ever have a job like this. When people, for the last couple years, they're like, oh, Tom should retire. Why should he retire? What do you do after being Tom Brady? I had a conversation with Peyton Manning this offseason. People were trying to get Peyton Manning to get back into football by broadcasting and everything. And Peyton pushing it off. But they're throwing so much money at him. Eventually, I believe Peyton will be in broadcasting. I believe after Eli retires, Peyton will get into broadcasting. But being around the game, there's nothing that will replace it. There's a lot of things that Peyton could do. But he's like, man, being there with the guys, there's nothing that will replace it. Playing there in New England, where they're going to have a competent game plan week in, week out, where he is challenged not only physically, but he's challenged intellectually on a week-to-week basis. That's the reason why he's one of the many reasons why he's been able to play so long. But Tom Brady is about trying to be the best ever. And he realizes that once he stops, there's not going to be anything to be able to do like this. And he enjoys playing football. And there's nothing wrong with that. Man, I enjoyed playing football. And if I could play it well, if I could have kept playing, I wouldn't have never went into television. Why would you? And I wouldn't quit if I was Tom Brady. Right now, still one of the best quarterbacks that we have in the game. And every year, they have a chance to win a Super Bowl after being the three straight. That's one of the main reasons to keep that run going.
And don't you think, like, when he looks back on it, because some people would say Tom Brady, well, I mean, he's already the greatest. So the mountain has already climbed and scaled and climbed again. Man, when Joe Montana retired, he was considered the greatest of all time. I bet there was a period when Joe Montana, when he saw Brady approaching, was like, man, maybe I should have held on for a few more years. Right. Maybe I should have widened that gap if he would have maybe won one with my Kansas City Chiefs when they got to an AFC championship game.
Joe Montana, the only reason why he stopped playing because he couldn't play anymore.
Right.
His body had given up on him. His back, his knees, shoulder. Like, he got knocked out of the game the way most of us do.
And Jerry Rice, do people, like, actually remember the last team Jerry Rice played for? Because it wasn't the Niners. It wasn't the Raiders. Was it Seattle? Because he wanted to keep going. Like, he, for most guys, we all remember Elway. But even Elway got to leave on top as far as a champion. But he didn't leave. He was get on his way to being forced out of the game. He could have kept going for another couple years. But when he won those Super Bowls, he wasn't the same guy that had gotten to the three previous. Sure. And so for Brady, when a lesser Brady, the one I'm talking about, is still, what, the fifth best quarterback in football last year during the regular season. He just went to three straight Super Bowls, as Chris mentioned, something he had never done previously in his career. Even when they won those three early on, they didn't go to three straight. So going to four straight Super Bowls, nobody's done that since the Buffalo Bills. Like, there are still new things he can accomplish that no one else has.
They have made it with the collective bargaining agreement. The offseason, you have less practices. Training camp is less physical. So the taxing on his body, right now, he's probably in the best shape ever. With modern technology, eating the right way, all the things Tom has said, that's one of the reasons why you can play. Protecting the passer. Ever since he blew out his ACL, when he got hit, the Kansas City Chief crawled and hit him on his leg, and the league changed the rules then, that extended his career. So there's a number of reasons why, but being able to be competitive, compete for Super Bowls, and this will be the best job he's ever had.
And last year, one of the lowest sack rates of his career, Chris talked about how they became a run-heavy team. They are asking him to do less and protecting him more when they need to, because, A, they're going one direction when the league's going another, but, B, their personnel demands it. He's not in the level of jeopardy other positions are, other players are, and he's still playing at such a high level.
All right, Tom Brady's going to play. You know who might not? Ezekiel Elliott. Ooh. Coming up. Should Zeke's contract be the Cowboys' top priority?